I had two pieces of cake and at home with my wife, which was okay. Lime cream cake, actually, which is something quite unusual, I guess. Lime cream. So it's like cream cake, but the cream actually is infused with lime flavors. So it's sort of sour, but still very good. Very, very interesting taste, basically. But the cake itself wasn't that good. I mean, it's supposed to be kind of, you know, the cake is supposed to be lemon cake, and then there's lots of lime infused cream, but the cake itself wasn't very nice. The texture was a bit dry, but the cake was kind of, it was quite funny. It was made like a lime, a lime cut in half. And yeah, that's why I bought it. I thought, you know what, it's okay, not too much of a waste of money, I guess. It's okay. It's US dollars 18? Let me think. US dollars 17. Okay, 17 US dollars. But it's already the third day already. So yeah, so it's okay. So it could be eaten for 3 days. Actually the fourth day, because we've stopped, but there's still a quarter left. So it's funny because it isn't a big cake, but like, if you wanna lose weight or anything, you should like consider, like, just have small bites and then consider whether, like, you know, have a few and then consider whether, alright, is this enough, you know, and then if it's enough, then just put it away, because there's this diminishing returns. You don't really have to study. Hey, I've got, what? I didn't know what. Did I beat 2 ARPAs? When did I do that? Anyway. Yeah, so it just kind of, I mean, probably the utility or the happiness from eating the whole cake, like, whole cake is 4 quarters, right, compared to a quarter of the cake isn't 4 times as much. That's the whole gist behind diminishing returns, which many people know. And it's also good on the wallet and good on going on the diet. So yeah, I like cake. I like cheesecake as well. I'm going to try the cheesecake from my local supermarket. That only costs 4 US dollars. Is it 4? Yeah, it's 4 US dollars. Pretty good. And I bet it's going to taste okay. So you know what? While we are, since there's nothing else to talk about, I'll continue talking about cake. I think I should edit out the random stuff I talked about before. And then we'll have this whole Valkyrie Crusade free talk on cakes only. So I was talking about like the frozen cheesecake that was US dollars 4, which is quite good, actually, I think. Because I had the same brand of pound cake that's frozen. Yeah, and then it's very easy. Like, suppose you want to eat the cake tonight, then before you go to work or go to school or whatever, or before you start your marathon gaming session, you can just take the frozen cake, you know, and then put it into the lower bit of the, well, can't say lower bit, but you know, there's the freezer and then there's the other bit which you put kind of you cool the food, but it's not frozen, that bit, the big bit. So you put the cake in the big bit, and then by the time you come home from work, come home from school, or finish your gaming session, the cake should be soft enough. You know, before I thought I should, you know what, cut the cake first and then do that, but then I realized that, you know, it's frozen. It's like I need a hatchet or an axe to do that, and then so I just gave up. It's actually not good practice if you freeze something, defreeze it, and then freeze it again. But yeah, But, you know, cake doesn't... Well, you wouldn't know, but... Tell you something, cake doesn't last very long in my house. In my apartment, you know. It's just, yeah. It's something that gets diligently removed. Not removed, or processed. Right? I like cake. I like cheesecake. I like the New York style cheesecake. That's very good. I don't like the Japanese style cheesecake. You know, the fluffy type, the Japanese style cheesecake. My wife and I went to Japan to travel, okay? And then we went to Fuji Mountain, and then there was this, like, huge pond or something. And then we were walking along the road, and then we found this kind of... It was quite interesting. It was a small outlet for a farm nearby. And then it has this, like, special cheesecake, right? And it only sells, like, 20, like, per day, right? And then when we got there, they just started selling. And then, well, there weren't a whole line of people there, but, you know, it's still... almost used the shoe. And then so we decided, you know what, we're on travel, and then so we should, you know, just kind of maybe experience the special stuff as well. You know, just kind of see what it's like. They did say it's from a farm nearby, and then, you know, a small farm. And it's interesting, so we had the cheesecake, which isn't very cheap, let's put it that way. But then we thought, you know, it smells very nice, looks very nice. I poked my fork in it. It's like jelly. It's like totally, you know, my wife doesn't like soft cheesecake as well. And we were like, dude, why? Yeah, so that was... So what ended up was we ate like kind of... Because they only sell it by the cake, which is quite, you know, I was like totally... It's like you buy something and then it's like, you know, should I eat it? If I eat it, I have to lose. I have to go to the gym. If I don't eat it, well, I can't chuck it in the restaurant, right? It's like, oh, you're, you know, a special cake, 20, you know, 20 per day cake. And then it's like you take two bites and then like, hey, dude, it sucks. And then you throw it in the trash. And probably start a war or something. You know, that Chinese dude threw away our cake. Start a war with him. But anyway, so we ended up packing it. I can speak Japanese, and I told the old lady, which was even worse, right? Because you chuck the cake that the old lady baked and was very, very, very proud of it. And then just chuck it in front of her. It's like, dude, your cake sucks. Yeah. And then, what is this? Oh, wow, okay. And then, yeah, so we ended up taking the cake back to the hotel. Yeah, and it was like with us on the train. And then on the bus as well, because you have to change. You know, we have to go back to the city where our hotel is. And then we took the train. And then we took the bus. And then we took it back to the hotel. Right? And by that time, it was like... I mean, it was soft to start with. By that time, it felt like it was going to... dissolve or melt any point. So we put it in the fridge, and then after a few days, when we were about to leave, we suddenly remember, like behind the cans of beer in the fridge, that you know, there's still that cake there, right? And then we took it out, had a taste. You know, probably you're expecting a plot twist by now. It's like, we put it in the fridge and it became so frozen that it's harder, and then we took a bite and then wow, it was awesome. No, that didn't happen. You know, so it was like, it did become frozen, but it's like, yeah, it's like having cheese flavored ice, not in the good way. I mean, imagine it's like, it's just ice flakes with a little cheese flavor on it. He just threw it away, I'm sorry. He just threw it away. And then, it was a waste of money, a waste of probably good cheese. And probably, actually, they say like they only bake 20, they probably only sell 3 or 4 or something. But it couldn't be. I remember there were lots of people going into the... Well, actually, lots of clueless tourists like me and my wife. They're like looked at the sign and says, hey, they only sell 20, gotta have that cake. I mean, it costs 4 times as much as the normal cake. And so, yeah, I guess the moral of the story is, even if it is limited edition cake, you know, if you gotta look at the whole thing holistically, right? You were, like, I was in Japan. Japan, like, normally has soft cheesecake. They call it fluffy cheesecake. Like, fuwa fuwa, right? That's what they call it. And then, actually, the more fluffy it is, you know, the, like, Japanese people, like, I mean, I can't say, like, all Japanese people, I mean, that's, like, kind of stereotyping, and it's never accurate. I mean, it's like saying, oh, all Chinese people eat noodles or something like that, right? That's a very, very lazy way of analyzing things. Anyway, so I would say a majority of Japanese people like the fluffy type. You know, my Japanese teacher liked the fluffy type. My Japanese, well, ex-co-workers liked the fluffy type. So probably all the Japanese I know like the fluffy type, actually. So probably it was quite popular. But anyway, so what I was trying to say is that so I was in Japan, and it's a very popular cheesecake. So probably it would mean it's fluffy. And if it's fluffy, it's not the type I like. And I probably should have saved that money to maybe, I don't know, buy jewels and summon and put it online so everybody can see. Yeah, that would probably bring me more enjoyment, actually. So I didn't have to, you know, hold that cake box for the whole journey. Anyway, so I guess that's the story of me and cheesecake many years ago in Japan. Makes me hungry, actually. Is it done yet? The bonus area? I'm just trying to... like kind of like streaming, where you have to think of stuff to talk about while you play. And yeah, okay, all right, I'll keep going. All right, let's stay on the topic of cake. Make this video like 20 minutes long or something. Cake, you know, I've been watching TV, and then there's this like on the cable, and then you guys probably have it as well. It should be global. So there's this channel that has this, like, I forgot the name. Was it Cake Boss or Cake Shop Boss or something, right? So he made this huge cake, but every time he makes a huge cake, it just seems to be, he bakes cake, right? And then he slabs like these kind of sugar stuff on top, so there's different colors. You know, I saw that episode where they were making like a kind of a commemoration for a butcher shop. So there's like, hey, I'm gonna make a huge cake. I'm gonna make it look like slabs of meat, different cuts of meat. And then so he baked the cake, like it was a huge cake. And then he just made different bits of red sugar coating on top. I looked at it, and then, you know, when I was small, I tried that kind of sugar coating. It wasn't nice. You know, cream is nice. But the sugar coating is just, you know, it's as if it's... it's just there to make the cake look like something else, right? If you have it, then it's just too sweet. Way too sweet. Way, way, way too sweet. Yeah. I guess because I'm older than when I was younger, so I prefer stuff that has more flavor as opposed to just sweet. I usually like Twix a lot. You know, the golden package and then Twix, it's like got caramel cookies and then I got biscuits, right? You call that biscuit, and then it was covered in chocolate. That type of snack. 250 calories for two of those. When I was in university, when I just started university, every morning I had a cup of coffee, and then I had two tricks. One I ate just like that, and the other I kind of dunk it in my coffee and then eat it. So it like just melted. Very, very nice. Very, very nice. And then a while ago, so that was years ago, my wife decided to buy me Twix because she saw it in the supermarket. And now I haven't had it for a few years, actually, ever since I came back from the United Kingdom. The UK. Never got the accent, unfortunately. Otherwise, I would sound British. Anyway, so, yeah, so I did that, and I thought, it's so sweet. It's too sweet. When I look at the packaging, it's like 250 calories. You know, back then I didn't count my calories. Like, sort of. I guess I did, but not as much. Now, it's like, especially I'm older and my metabolism is lower. 250 calories, it's like a lot. It's like, you know, it's like, it probably is half a burger, right? It's like, do you want half a burger? Or do you want two Twix, right? So, yeah. Anyway, so that just brings back to the story that, you know, going back to the cake topic. You know, when I have cake now, I try to think very, very carefully. Because cake is also expensive now that I have a mortgage and all that, right? It's you know, anyway, I guess the moral of the story, again, another moral of the story is when you're young, you know, try stuff, eat stuff. Because when you get older, there are lots of constraints that you give yourself, right? And then you wouldn't enjoy the sort of cake as much as you do when you are young, I guess. Alright, that's two bonus areas. That's probably like 40 minutes of footage. Well, sorry to take it that long. Anyway, I think if you survived until now, congratulations. And also, thank you very much for watching. And let's look forward to the Alliance Bingo Battle, which I think is about to start very soon, or about to be announced very soon. Okay, thank you very much for watching.